It's Imani. Welcome back to my channel. And today I am doing my part one to my Peloton Bike Plus review. And honestly, I'm super excited to do this review for you all because honestly, I really, really love this bike. And I just hope that while you're on your journey to deciding if this bike is the one for you, that my experience will help you decide if you should get the bike. First things first, I do want to say that this is a collab with my girl, Life with Lex. She has a part one Bike Plus review as well. So if you watch her video and you come over here, welcome. But also, please make sure if you're watching my video that you go watch hers. And if you do, write down in the comments that I sent you. So let's get into it. So first things I want to get into is why did I purchase it? Because I'm pretty sure everyone that watches a review is like, why did you get the bike? But before I tell you why I got it, let me let you in on a little secret. I never wanted it. And you're probably like, what? What are you talking about? Yes, I never wanted the bike. In college, I had this cheap stationary bike. And it just really got on my nerves. Like, I didn't know how to do the resistance. It just wasn't my thing. I was like, I'll never get a bike again. I hate them. So when I would see the commercial, I'm like, yeah, never getting one. Because I'm like, no, I thought that they were the same. Clearly they're not. But I really was adamant about not getting the bike. Then the pandemic hit, and I am not a fan of high intensity interval training cardio, HIIT cardio, and it was a real inconvenience for me to work out because I didn't like HIIT cardio. Didn't mean I didn't do it, but I really wasn't a fan of it. My other option was running. And what if it's raining all day? Or what if I can't go before the sun sets? It really inconvenienced me. And you know, yes, I could get a treadmill, but I just wanted something that was more interactive and just more fun. And that's when I decided to pull the trigger and get the Peloton. And I'll probably say this all the time in this entire video. I love the bike, okay? And honestly, I couldn't be happier that I purchased it. So even though I was cracking jokes about it in the beginning, it was like, I'll never get one. I'm honestly really happy that I did. Now, if you look up Peloton, I'm pretty sure across the entire Google, there's constant articles and complaints about how long the bike took. So I'm just going to share my experience with you all on how long it took. So I ordered my bike October 27th. 2020. And it's funny because when I ordered the bike, the first delivery date was January 8th. And I was just like, damn, like that is a long time. To be honest, like I've never waited that long for anything. Like, you know, and you know, I'm a millennial, so I want stuff like that. So I was just like extremely, extremely impatient about the bike. But then I want to say like 3 weeks later, they emailed me and said, oh, we have an earlier bike date. Click this link and decide what date works for you. So I moved my bike delivery date up to December 8th. So I'm like, okay, that's not bad. That's like a month and a half that I have to wait for the bike. I don't think that that's bad. I know sometimes like when you order stuff that's not like highly in demand, it could take up to 2 weeks, but I'm like, okay, it's highly in demand. It's extremely in demand. So it's like, fine. I have to wait a month and a half. That's not bad compared to my original delivery date. Now this is where, honestly, I was very disappointed in Peloton's customer service. Because two business days before my bike was going to be delivered, they told me that they now have to push it to December 29th. And at this point, I'm like, how do you not know by 5 to 10 business days that you will not have the bike available for me to order, I mean, for it to be delivered? I would not think that 2 business days you guys then realize. Like, that was a tad bit confusing for me. And honestly, I'm not gonna lie, I was pissed because I just did not understand that. But, you know, I sucked it up and I was just like, whatever. But I was really anxious to get the bike because I was just tired of the high intensity. Because at this point it's cold, so I can't run. So it was like the only way I'm gonna get my cardio in is if I do high intensity interval training. So I was tired of doing my HIIT cardio and my strength workouts. Like, I just was getting bored. And I was like, I need to mix this up with HIIT and my bike. And, you know, this was slowing things down for a girl, you know what I'm saying? So I was, you know, a little irritated, but it did come on December 9th. It did. So, you know, I'm good now. But I was a little pissed when I originally found out that my date was getting pushed back. So let's get into purchasing the bike. So I purchased my bike on the Peloton website. I actually never seen the bike in person, but I just was going off a whim and was like, I'm gonna get this bike. Like, I just trusted my gut. At this point, I watched so many reviews on YouTube to the point where I was like, I know what this bike looked like in person. I don't need to see it. Like, that's how thorough I was about getting this bike. So I just purchased it online, and there's various packages that you could get with the Peloton bike. They have, you know, the basic, which I believe is just the bike. You don't get anything. And then they have the essentials, which comes with cycling shoes, dumbbells, and a workout mat, which is what I got. And the dumbbells I ordered were 3 pounds, and I got cycling shoes and the bike mat. Then they have the Bike Works, which comes with the bike, workout, well, cycling shoes, the workout mat, a resistance band, and the bike mat, which honestly I should have ordered for $100 more, but I did not realize that they sent me a workout mat instead of the bike mat. But I ordered the bike mat when I went to the Peloton store because I did actually want to see it in person. And then they have the bike family package, which is honestly really good because if you have another rider in the house, you guys can get cycling shoes, you get a bottle, you get the yoga blocks, the yoga strap, like you get the bike mat and you get the workout mat, so you get a lot more. But I should have got that, but my husband did say he wasn't gonna ride the bike, but that's part two conversation. But so I ended up getting the bike essentials. The funniest thing about Peloton that honestly I do think this is hilarious. So if you order any accessories for your bike, honestly, I will say that it will take 2 to 3 business days for you to get it. And it's just funny because you would think as long as it takes for you to get the actual bike, that everything else will be delayed. But no, like, I ordered my bike mat, I want to say a week before my anticipated delivery date was, and I got the bike mat right like 2 days after I ordered, 2 business days after I ordered it. I just bought my husband's cycling shoes, and we got them, I want to say 3 business days after we ordered them. So it's really funny. Like, if you want a water bottle or whatever the case is, you'll get that right away. But this bike right here, you definitely gonna wait for it. Like, you're gonna wait for the bike. So the total price of the bike, including taxes and delivery, was $2,934.21. And I did the financing option with a firm, which is no interest for 39 months. So I wanna get into the features of the bike. So as you can see, the bike is behind me and it's 4 feet tall and it's 2 inches wide. So on the website, they suggest that you have 2 feet of space on the bike on each side. So like 2 feet in the front, 2 feet on the left, the right side, and 2 feet in the back, just to give you an idea about the spacing. I know a lot of people say, oh, I would love to have a Peloton, but I don't have the space for it. And if you go on the official Peloton member page, people make it work. They make it work. So don't feel like you need a whole room or a whole workout area to have this bike. You don't. All you need is 2 feet in the front, in the back and on the sides, and you're good to go. Also, the screen. The screen is 23.8 inches, and what I really do like about the screen is that it rotates 360. So it'll rotate 180 to the left, and it'll rotate 180 to the right. So it can't like go around completely like a 360, but it does rotate 180 on both sides. What I also like is that there's speakers in the front, so I never have an issue with audio, and you actually can connect it to Bluetooth. I have issues connecting it to my AirPods, and honestly, when I work out, I don't work out really late or really early, so it's not that loud where I'm disturbing anyone. But I do have a speaker on my vanity mirror, so I actually do connect it to that when I want that extra oomph and just a little bit more music. So I do like the Bluetooth connectivity, but it does have an audio jack that you can connect to if you would like to just put your headphones in. What's also really cool is they do have a video chat feature. So if you have friends on here on your Peloton membership, because you can follow people and they'll follow you back, or vice versa, social friends pretty much, or personal, you can video chat with them if you're on the ride with them, which I really like, because you know, sometimes you just need that extra motivation. Sometimes you're like, girl, I want to talk to you, but I need to ride my bike. And then, you know, y'all can set up a, you know, conversation like that where y'all, you know, can not really chat. Well, no, you could, because you could do like a scenic route, which is really cool. That's one of the features on here where you can literally be anywhere in the world and it's a picturesque view of it. And you can literally talk to your friends through there, because all you're doing is pedaling. It's not a hard class like a live class with an instructor. That you do kind of do your own thing, or if you want to do like a just ride where the screen is just black and you're just riding the bike, you could do that as well. So I do like the video chat feature. Another feature that is really cool that the regular bike, well, the first bike doesn't have, is the auto resistance feature. I personally don't use it, but if you're someone that feels like it takes you too long to get to the resistance, or you just don't want to have to do it, or you would rather it get there and then you just turn the knob up or turn the knob down, the auto resistance feature is a great feature for you, because you don't have to worry about it. Me personally though, it always goes in the middle. So if the instructor calls a 55, 65 resistance, I've seen it happen before, don't look at me like I'm crazy, it'll go to 60 and it's like, girl, I could barely do 55. So that's why I don't do it. But if you're someone that's, you know, been cycling for a while, that would actually be a good feature for you to use. Another feature that a lot of people like is the Apple Gym Kit feature. And that's basically where you, if you're an Apple Watch user, all you have to do is connect your watch to the bike, just the top of it, and it will automatically connect. I don't know what's going on, but recently the bike did an update and my Apple Watch did an update, and I can't connect my bike to my watch anymore. So that is extremely frustrating, and I hope that it's fixed, because right now what I'm doing is I'm logging in my cycling stuff to my watch exercise app, which is cool. But what ends up happening is when I go on my Peloton app, the Peloton app tracks how much calories I've burned and stuff like that just based off my cadence, which is completely incorrect. It will mess up my rings, and for some odd reason, Apple will then take the calories they said I burned and use that instead of what my Apple Watch said. It's crazy. So that's why I'm highly annoyed about it, because I'm very serious about my rings. Like, I don't play, and like, it's messing up right now. So I hope that that gets fixed soon. Hey guys, I was actually able to figure out how you can fix the Apple Gym Kit issue. Go to Home Installation, and then you're gonna click Calibrate, and that will reset the bike. So once you do that, your Apple Watch should work fine with your bike. What's another thing I really love about the bike is the live classes. I love the live classes because it feels like you're there with the instructor. And if you're hitting a milestone or if it's your birthday, they actually will shout you out. So that, you know, it's that extra motivation. And it's really nice when you're on the leaderboard and other people that are riding with you high five you. I high five people all the time just to give them that extra motivation and let them know, like, it's good that you clipped in today, even if you didn't feel like it. So I just love that what I really love about the bike, honestly, is the interactive part of it. And that's what sold me compared to regular spin bikes with no screen and, you know, other brands that are similar, but, you know, they're just not Peloton. That's what sold me, was the interactiveness. And I mean, they did a collab with Beyonce, for crying out loud. Their music is really good. You know, I could go on and on about the instructors, but that will be in part two. This is the end of this video. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, please like, don't forget to comment, and most importantly, subscribe if you made it to the end. I really do appreciate all the support, and I will see y'all for part two. And don't forget, if you got to the end, go check out Life with Lex, and I will see y'all in my next video. All right, bye y'all.